So an interesting thing happened after Donald Trump's triumphant entry into the RNC. Dramatically backlit, queen blazing, smoke machines churning, the Donald took the stage like a gilded gold rock star. And how was this received? Trumpers were ecstatic. They felt vindicated in their triumph. The left, the progressives, took to Facebook and Twitter to ask America, do you really think this WWE wrestling clown can win the presidency?
Hey, look at this! Donald Trump!
Only time will tell. But the answer is yes. But hey, let's go back a few months, back to around April. It seemed like every news site on the planet was running a story about Donald Trump's wrestling career. Fusion, Vice, Rolling Stone, The Washington Post, all ran stories. Even NPR led with the headline, Four Ways Donald Trump's Pro Wrestling Experience is Like His Campaign Today. The always fair and balanced Huffington Post led with the headline, That Time Donald Trump Clotheslined Vince McMahon on WrestleMania. But what's really interesting about their article is the comments section. Let me read a few of them for you. This man wants to be leader of the free world? I can see the news stories now. President Trump settled a trade dispute with Germany today by clotheslining Angela Merkel and finishing her off with an elbow drop. Yet another, I remember watching the movie Idiocracy and thinking the depiction of the president was a little too absurd. Even with the context of the movie, clearly I was wrong. Another, I never want to hear another Republican saying anything about how this or that Democrat is not acting sufficiently presidential. There was a voice of reason in the comments section of the Huffington Post in the form of Bill Maher, who wrote, Hilarious! I love it! Any and everyone should know this is all made up and acted out for entertainment. And therein lies what's interesting about this entire situation. Donald Trump was clearly acting out a character. The character may have had the same name. He may have been playing himself, but nonetheless, it was a character. It was not the real Donald Trump. As much as progressives would like us to believe that his appearances on the WWE are an indication of how he would govern if elected president, it's simply not the case. Now let's switch gears a little bit. Let's talk about someone who is also playing a character, but is not being honest about doing so.
We have to stay awake. We have a march to finish. On this Lord's Day, let us say with one voice the words of James Cleveland's great freedom hymn. I don't feel no ways tired. I come too far. From where I started from, nobody told me that the road would be easy. I don't believe he brought me this far to leave me.
What in the fuck?
In an op-ed dated September 11th of 2007, shortly after Mrs. Clinton's remarks, Walter E. Williams, a successful black economist, wrote the following, entitled Insulting Blacks. The occasion of Mrs. Clinton's speech was the 42nd anniversary of Bloody Sunday on March 7th, 1965, when 600 civil rights marchers were attacked by police with billy clubs, cattle prods, and tear gas, one of the high points in the Black civil rights struggle. Commemorating a key point in American history is one thing, but a white person mimicking Black dialect is demeaning and insulting. So what is there to say in conclusion? On one hand, we have progressives and progressive media outlets criticizing Donald Trump for playing a character on a television show. Yet looking back at the news coverage of the Clinton event, one finds that she is largely given a pass by the same media outlets. And it comes down to this. Both candidates were playing a character, but only one was honest about it.
Doing it right, everybody will be dancing and we're feeling it right. Everybody will be dancing and be feeling it right. Everybody will be dancing and we're feeling alright. Everybody will be dancing tonight, doing it right. Everybody will be dancing and we're feeling it right. Everybody will be dancing.